Hey guys, so I know it's a little late, but I still wanted to share my 2016 favorites with you because I usually stick to what I like and don't really change up my routine a lot. But in 2016, I've actually found a few products that have kind of changed my life and been incorporated into my daily routine. So I'd like to share those with you guys because I do think that they're pretty nice products and worth trying out. I'm going to start with makeup products first. I am a huge lippy hoarder when it comes to kinds of makeup products. I don't know if you guys do that, but like I always buy lip products because they're really pretty, even though I know that I have some of the things similar in my drawer, but they're similar, they're not the same, and I feel like I have to get them, and just because they're like just slightly different. So I actually have these two products always in my wallet, no matter what I am wearing that morning. I always have these because I just think that they go well with everything, and just in case my lipstick comes off or I'm at a really random place that is really hard to put on like precisely some lip product, I always keep these in my bag just in case. So the first thing is my Dior Lip Glow Color Reviver Balm in 04 Coral. I am like to the bottom of this. Like you can't really, that's it. I can't like put it higher. And yeah, it has been about a year since I've been using this. Yeah, so I really like it. It's very moisturizing. Sometimes I just put this on without anything and it just helps give a little more color to my lips because my lips are quite like dull and not really pinky. My lips are very like dark colored, so this just gives me a little more like life and color in my face. So I really like this and I am sad to see it go, but I really do recommend this. I've heard that it's really popular and it always gets sold out, so definitely get your hands on this if you can find it. Another thing is Laneige, what is this? I think it's their oil tint. I don't really remember what the name for this is, but this color is from the Chouette collaboration, and this is in Misty Rose. I really, really like this. I've like gotten a lot of compliments on this. It's not a very watery formula. It's more like creamy than you would think a tint would be, and it's not drying at all. It's a little bit glossy feeling. It's not exactly sheer. It actually, the color payoff is really nice, so I really do love this, and I always just have this in my wallet because it's a little like my lips fit better and easy to put on, goes with everything color. Okay, on to eye makeup. There are two palettes that I've been loving recently, or this whole year. I've really only used these two products. They come as no surprise because people have talked about them for years, and they're the Naked palette and the Too Faced Natural Eyes. I think this one I got for my birthday the past year, so I really like them. The Naked palette is just a classic, like, I don't really have to explain why I like it. I just really love earth tones and it has a wide selection. And then the Too Faced Natural Eyes palette it's kind of similar. It's a little more warm toned than my Naked. The box is a little more sturdy, so I can bring it like to travel with me and I'd feel fine with just throwing it in my luggage. And I really like matte colors, so I've been using a lot of this matte colors because they do have there are four matte colors on this one and two on my Naked, but my Naked has like 12 colors. This has 9 colors. So depending on like what your preferences are and what kind of looks that you like, darker colors just make me look like I have a lot of makeup on. And for everyday purposes, I use a lot of these 6 lighter colors. And then I'm going to talk about 2 eyeliners that I found. The first one is a Clio Waterkill Pen Liner Kill Black. Long name, but I actually got this from Korea, and they sell them in Watsons in Hong Kong now, in some of the bigger Watsons. I used to use the Japanese One Day Tattoo. This one is really nice. It's very similar. I feel like it's a little more black than the Japanese one, and because the tip is a little shorter than the Japanese one, I feel like it's easier to control. So I've been using this like the whole year, and I really like it. I only use liquid eyeliner, so this is like my holy grail item, and I am going to buy more of this in my backup when I see them. Another eyeliner is also from Clio, and this is their Gelpresso Waterproof Pen Gel Liner. This is in the color Beige Shy Number 1, actually. This is a like one of their best-selling products. I really like to put this underneath my eyes, like on the lower lash line. So it's really popular in Asia to have like a little, like, it's not eye bag, but like a little like bulking on the bottom of your eyes, to highlight that so that your eyes look a little more youthful. I don't have that like naturally, but I like using this because it helps me kind of look a little more awake, and yes, it does make me look a little more youthful and less like matte. So I really do love this. It's very creamy, very pigmented, and it has like surpassed a lot of my other like beige or champagne color eyeliners, because this is just very soft, it stays, and it's very easy to put on. And then the next thing is my Roller Lash mascara from Benefit. This has gotten a lot of great reviews. The formula is great, it lifts my lashes, it volumizes and lengthens. It's like everything you can have, you can want in a mascara. It is, because I do have very oily eyes, eyeliner and mascara doesn't really stay on my eyes. This one, I feel like it does. It's not as great as some other waterproof mascaras that I've tried, but in the year of 2016, this is the one mascara that I found that I actually really like, other than my other Holy Grail mascaras. So I just wanted to mention it. And then I'm going to talk about these color contact lenses. I don't really wear a lot of color contact lenses. You have to have quite strong makeup to carry contact, like, circle lenses and not have you look like an alien. So I don't wear them often, but one brand that I found that is very natural on me is the One Day Acuvue Define. I have, I think this is the Shimmer version. I'm wearing it right now, but it's essentially like brown, and yeah, it's, the diameter is not that big, so it's very natural on a lot of people, and it just kind of helps define your eyes, make it sparkle a little more. I don't wear it every single day, but on days where I want to look good on photos, or when I have like a long day out, I wear these. Also, I trust the Acuvue brand a lot because my clear, like, normal contact lenses are also from them, and I've worn them since I was 15, so for like 5-6 years, and so I really do like them. They're not that pricey. They are a little more expensive than normal ones, but I do really like them. I'm going to move on to skincare. So the first skincare product is this Belif creamy cleansing foam moist that I talked about in my previous video, and actually a lot of my friends like it, and I also found it. I kind of just went to Belif and with a mindset that, oh, I really like their aqua balm, so why not try this creamy foam moist, just to try some random product from their line. And I ended up really liking it. It's it cleanses, but it's so moisturizing. Like, I don't feel like my skin is tight or stretched. It's for normal to dry skin, so I would really recommend this if you're trying to find a new foaming cleanser that is moisturizing. And yeah, this is a Korean brand, but I think you can get it from Sephora now. And moving on to hair products, I don't really mention a lot of hair products a lot because my hair is a natural color. I don't dye it, I don't perm it, I do nothing to it. So it's very boring. But it's quite healthy. But I do like finding products for my hair that gives me shine and volume and just treat my hair very nicely, because it is one thing that I'm very proud of and I really like. I've gotten a lot of compliments on my dark hair that it suits me very well. So the first thing that I want to talk about is this Lush Big Sea Salt Shampoo. I use this all summer because my hair does get quite oily and it is very humid, and like, I sweat a lot in the summer when I'm home in Hong Kong. So this one has helped me a lot. It has natural sea salts in it. It smells really nice. It says that have a big hair day, this is like having your hair lifted on a sea breeze. It does give my hair a lot of volume. It is a little harsher than what your normal shampoos would be, so I wouldn't recommend using it every single day, but I used it every other day when I was back home, and you can even use it every like once a week and you will get a lot of volume. I usually don't purchase a lot of Lush products because the fragrance is just so strong. But I really like this, and I do think that this is their best-selling shampoos. If you're looking into trying some Lush products, I would definitely recommend this, especially if you live in somewhere where it's very humid and if you want a lot of volume in your hair. The last thing is sunglasses. And not sure if you guys know, I am also a sunglass hoarder. I love buying new sunglasses, even though I sometimes don't remember bringing them out, and sometimes my bag is too small and I don't want to crush it. You guys know that I went to Korea and I bought my most expensive purchase there was from Gentle Monster, so I just wanted to give the brand another shout out. These are the ones that I bought when I was in Korea, and I really love them. You can totally see my camera and the reflection. Oh, look at the flower in my sunglasses. And I really like Gentle Monster because their designs are pretty unique, and they are very fashionable, but at the same time they suit Asian facial features. So it actually caters to Asian faces, so you don't have the problem of like your nose bridge not being tall enough and not like supporting the sunglasses how it should be. Those are my 2016 favorites. Please leave in the comments below what you would want me to do in videos for the year of 2017. I actually have quite a few video ideas. I just need the time to do them. So yeah, I will talk to you guys very soon, and I hope you guys have a wonderful new year. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Hello, cảm ơn.
More than anything, when you go home, you're like, this is why I do it, and this is why I want to continue to do it.